And of course, traders, don't forget to check out all the different drawings and indicators you guys can be using. I'm not going to go through every single one of these because that would take hours, guys, really hours to describe all these. But look into it. Of course, always click your down arrow, go to help. You'll be able to open up this and go a little bit deeper into it. But with the drawing basics, right, we could take a look there and see how this would look. And you guys can watch it, right? We can go to a little bit of an auto, or let's just manually zoom out a little bit here and draw a couple lines and patterns that you guys can see there, right? You guys see, I already have my lines defaulted as a little bit thicker. When you go see and you see this, you can always click the right arrow in the settings and kind of adjust this, right? You can synchronize it with the different charts. You can lock the location. You can change the thickness here in the line. That's what I changed because I put it as 4 in the yellow. And the biggest thing is setting it as a default, right? So that every time I grab the line, it's doing the same kind of yellow line that I want to see on my charts. And I like yellow just because it stands out there, right? Like you can clearly see that. I could see that from a mile away. You guys could probably see that even on my screen down here. Of course, we can also have different things here. We can have the snap to candle, right? That's going to bring me just right to that chant, right to that candle, right? And things like that. You can do a lock in the drawing mode. There's vertical lines. There's price channels, right? There's regression channels, right? Things like this are definitely something to use. And take a look into the different shapes that we have. We have Fibonacci retracements, expansions, right? I could do a Fibonacci retracement right here, right? So pretty much what you're going to be doing with this, and I'll adjust here because I'm on the manual, and when you're on the manual, you got to grab the screen, right? So there's the Fib. I can pull it here. I can take a look at the expansion. How is the retracement level? I can adjust these. I can go to the settings and make the lines thicker, right? The different points, different levels. I can use custom settings. If I wanted to make the level 2, maybe it's the 50% retracement stand out, I can come here. I can go ahead and say, you know what? I want to use custom settings. I want to use a line, and I want this line to be my green line, right? And I want it super thick so I can see this, right? And I want it to be a nice font here, and I want it to be nice custom level here to use there. And so we're going to use that. We're going to make it, let's make it green. We're going to hit okay. And then we can start to take a look at it, right? And what is that line that I want to go ahead and see, right? You guys can see it right there. It's giving me that ability right here to take a look at it, right? And so things like this are going to help you guys out. Definitely take a look into how you guys can be doing this and push into the next level. Of course, I would definitely kind of learn how do you use these indicators before you start dipping into them. But there's so many different ones. One of my favorite ones, right? You guys have Elliott impulse waves and things like this, things that I talk about all the time, like what's a ABC and then the DE move, right? Or maybe it's an ABC correction wave. I talk about these all the time, right? And another one here, the ruler. The ruler is an interesting one too within itself, right? You can see different arrows, comments. The ruler is an interesting one. You guys can see, and I could click here. I could click here. It's going to tell me there what kind of how this is measured out, right? This took here, what, 0.4 hours, 22 minutes. The price has gone up 52.52, right? So 52 cents, and it's 21%. Things like this are really interesting. And don't forget, you can always kind of adjust the way that it looks, right? Let's say you wanted to maybe stand out a little bit more so I can read it. I can make it a little bit thicker here. And I think that's important too. And then that way, now you can clearly see it, right? When it's on the screen. Things like this are going to help you guys. And don't forget this one. This is a great one. Let's go to my Picard trade here as I take a look at it in a daily chart. And let's talk a little bit more about what's going on here. As you guys can see here, I did some drawings there that I'm trying to take off. What can I do, guys? I'm struggling here. How can I do it? I can't click it. I can't take it off. Well, just go to the object, right? The object manager. I go to the drawing here and I remove it. Simple as that, guys. A good thing that I was able to do there, right there, and show you guys it, right? So this is my position, right? But let me go ahead and let's say if I wasn't in the position, I wanted to calculate it, right? I click right here. This is where I'm planning on getting in, the stop level. Well, I want to risk down here and risk towards, let's say, the $98, right? So I have it at 98. Boom, boom. I set it at 98. And if for any reason you want to kind of adjust this, you can always go to the settings and you can go into the points and you can adjust the settings here exactly, right? The appearance you can change too. If you want to change the colors and anything that you want to do there. Or maybe you want to move it in the background so it's not so focused. That's another thing that I like to do also. So another thing that you're going to do there is when you zoom in, you can see here how you have profit take, profit to loss ratio right there. So now I'll know, hey, how much am I going to make on this if it goes up towards, let's say, 108? So if it goes up to 108, right, now at that point, right, I'm not going to put it exactly. You can always adjust it, right? You can make it, you can just right click and kind of adjust that. That's going to be 7.99%, right? That's a $729 trade with the quantity that I'm trying to do. And that's the important part here. The risk to return is very important, 3.92. So I'm risking 2% to make 8%. And that's important, right? That's going to help me out, definitely determine trades. Always want to make that box of profit, right? Bigger than the risk box and things like that. But I recommend to do this, especially for newer traders. If you can do this, this is going to help you stick to your rules so that when you see the stock go to your stop, you do get out. Right? Definitely something to look into, guys. I would definitely use this, especially if you're a new trader. All right, guys, that was a little bit of an added bonus there and definitely would recommend looking into here. You can also set this bell. You see this click create alert. So let's say if I wanted to alert myself when this price was going to go through 105. Well, you can set that right there on the chart. There's different ways to use this. And look into our alerts video. Michael does a great video on this. You guys can look at it in our playlist here to learn a little bit more about alerts, but definitely take a look at alerts. You got to set them on the settings. You go here to your alerts, make sure that you hit show alerts, all notifications, and then you can take a look here and maybe remove after execute, stop things like that. Definitely take a look into it of how you can be best using the alerts. All right, guys, there's tons of things to do with, of course, our charting. And don't forget that you could always like kind of right click on different areas to learn a little bit more about it. And if you have any questions on the charts or anything that I went through today, please reach out.